Hello, welcome to March. I nearly said February because I just watched a monthly vlog from February. Not mine, Melanie Murphy's. I like hers. Anyway, we're just chilling out. It's pancake day today.
We get to have pancakes.
Yeah, we're gonna have pancakes later. That's cool. And then I was thinking about what I should give up for Lent. And like 2 years ago was the last time I seriously gave up something for Lent. And what I gave up was meat. But I just kind of continued that. And I still don't eat meat to this day. So I thought, well, what else can I give up? And I've decided I want to give up pudding. That doesn't mean sweet things in general, like cut out all chocolate or cake or whatever. It just means if I have a meal, not to have a pudding afterwards. That's my challenge for the next 40 days.
So we've got to eat lots and lots of pudding tonight.
Well, that's going to be in the form of pancakes.
That many?
I don't know if I'm going to be able to stomach that many.
Stack them that high. That many pancakes.
Yeah, sure.
That's Oliver the Owl.
That's Oliver the Owl, apparently. My little owl is Oliver. Yeah, I'll go with that. It's Oliver the Owl.
It's quite clearly not Hedwig, so...
Oh, it's quite clearly not Hedwig, yeah, definitely. Hey, speaking of Melanie Mercy's monthly vlog, I really like her vlogs, by the way. She does really good monthly vlogs. I recommend checking them out. Anyway, she said something about, she mentioned one of her cats, Molly Weasley. I love the fact that a cat's called Molly Weasley. Likes to be smacked on the bum. Now, I know about cats that like to be stroked on the bum and, you know, their bums just go up in the air and they're like, ooh, I want to show off my bottom and all this kind of stuff. But she was like smacking her cat's bottom and it was enjoying it. And I just went to our cat and started smacking her bum and she liked it too, so...
Cats like to be spanked.
Yeah, I don't know if it's just like female cats just like to have their asses just patted on, you know, or if it's all cats in general, or most cats in general. Anyway, welcome to March. Let's see what goes on the rest of March. We're gonna go get some pancakes. And yeah, let's enjoy the rest of the month. Yeah.
I'm really good at this.
Mm. Oh, in one.
Oh, look at the light, it looks all weird. Hello, we are now off to a Harry Potter quiz, the second Harry Potter quiz I shall ever attend. I'm kind of going all Hufflepuff style right now. I've got a Harry Potter t-shirt on underneath one of the new Geek Gear ones. Yeah, we're gonna have a burger. Have some drinks, getting a wand and a quill apparently, and should be fun. And I'm hoping it's not going to be quite as difficult as the last one, but we'll see. We're at the quiz, and look at this cute little presentation. So they've made their own wands. We have a quill to write the answers with. We got this thing, I don't know what's in there. We got this, I guess it's the quiz, I don't know. And we, of course we had to go for Hogwarts hexes. And yeah, that's just really cool.
I look very gay right now.
Coming back from the quiz now, I didn't really feel that comfortable vlogging while I was there, partly because the person doing it was doing reading out the questions was stood right next to us, so I don't know, I just felt a bit nervous. I'm shivering, it's so bloody cold. I can't even talk properly. But yeah, it was just me and Scott on our team, just me, because
I was no help at all.
Scott doesn't really know much about Harry Potter, so really just me, and there's other groups of like loads of people and stuff. It was much easier than the last quiz we did, which I'm very glad about. It was more canon questions than film questions, which is good. And yeah, did all right. And I kept the quill. We got a little quill, which is basically just a biro pen kind of glued to a feather, which is cool. Really cool. But yeah, I suppose the best news, without trumping my own horn, is that the right word?
Blowing your own horn.
Without blowing my own horn.
Blowing your own trumpet.
Blowing my own trumpet. Whatever the phrase is.
There's a phrase in there somewhere.
But best news is, I got second place.
Not 68 and a half out of 71.
68 and a half out of 71. Two questions I will kick myself at not getting. Which character taught Harry about the unforgivable curses? I obviously put Moody without thinking. And obviously it was Barty Crouch Jr. Kicked myself for that. And the other one is, who was the first owner of the invisibility cloak? I can't talk. And I put Ignatius Pruitt thinking, no, Peveril. I did put Pruitt and then crossed it out and put Peveril because Pruitt is Lily's, no, Molly's maiden name. I cannot talk. I was thinking I was all smart because I remembered Ignatius Pruitt, Peveril, whatever the bloody name is, but no, it was Death, wasn't it? Death gave Ignatius Peveril his own cloak, and that's another one I was like, oh, of course. But yeah, it was really good. Really good. It was really fun. And they're doing more quiz nights, so hopefully we'll do more. That'll be fun.
And I cannot help again.
You were very helpful on one question, which was, what was Hermione's Patronus? I knew what it was, I just could not think of the name of the animal.
I
was like, name a water animal, name a water animal. And the first thing he said was vole, and I said, no, but it's like that. He said otter. I was like, yes, that's the one, otter. I'm still very anxious. I get anxious when I'm in public places around people who are into Harry Potter, because it's something I'm not used to. I said that the last time. I'm very tired. I got work again in the morning. And it's like, it's 10:30 at night. That's...
We're old, that's why.
I was just about to say, we're getting old. But yeah, now, time to go home. Just a little weirdo, aren't you, Aggie?
You are such a role model for me, and I should probably tell you that.
Look at his lovely belly, and his little footsies. You get little footsies.
I don't know what I'd do without you. You're amazing,
man. It's all so tickly, isn't it? So tickly. Oh, so tickly. Oh, you little weirdo. Ooh! Committing suicide. Oh, Evie. Oh, Evie. Oh, Evie! Oh, Evie! The 21st of March 2019, and I have a nice little update about our house. So you know I said that we were delayed another month and they were going to say the end of this month? Well, my partner Scott came down on them like a ton of bricks, you know, complaining about all this stuff, and he demanded to get it like reassessed, I guess. Basically, the house is ready and we're moving in today. Like, we're actually finally moving house today. I literally cannot believe it's finally happening. We've been here for three and a half months, something like that. The fact that we were originally told, the original plan was that we were going to move in at the end of November or like December at some point, and then no, it was the end of February, and then it was the end of March, and it just, the whole thing just got so frustrating. I don't know if you saw how frustrated I got in these videos. But it was really hard on me. It's been really hard on me staying in somebody else's house. It's always something I've struggled with, especially when it's not my own family. You've always got that thing in the back of your head. Yes, the people here welcomed us here and they've been so good to us and so nice, kind, and you know, all this stuff. It was never going to be their choice for us to move in, and it would never have been our choice to move in here. So that was really hard on me. And you know, I'm not comfortable around people a lot of the time, and I feel like I'm in the way and a burden and all this stuff. I'm just so glad it's finally happening. And you know, not only has it been hard on me about the whole thing that I just said, but we've been away from a lot of our stuff. You know, most of my Harry Potter collection has been in storage for the last few months. So I've not been able to appreciate that. I miss my bookshelf, I miss all of my stuff. And, you know, not even just the Harry Potter stuff, our own sofas, our own house stuff, you know, our own space. I miss having our own space. But this house is so full of dogs, and every single morning you hear them just all running downstairs because they live in cages upstairs in the night. And it's just like, just loads of little things, you know, and lots of restrictions. It all sounds a bit petty, I know, because I should be grateful, and I've been so grateful to these two, for my boyfriend's parents, for putting us up, especially me, because I'm not even family. But I don't know, I've just got loads of stuff going in my head right now. I'm packing all my things upstairs. I need to really carefully pack my Hogwarts castle sculpture back in its box that it got delivered in, and we're just moving things. We got a van full from the storage unit last night. We got a van full of our stuff outside right now. That's Scott's sister's van. Scott's dad also has a van, so today we're planning on unloading the stuff we have in the van, I think, first, maybe. You know, the fridge freezer's in there, so that's one of the first things we want to get sorted out. But then we're going to have two vanfuls and Scott's little car all in the storage unit at the same time, and just pack bulk loading and unloading, and just having this huge sesh. And we're going to have a Chinese tonight. And, oh, it's just, I'm so happy to finally... It's been an emotional morning. I've really been emotional, you know, taking down all the Harry Potter stuff that I've got in that room, in that tiny little room that I've had for the last 3 months. I'm packing all of my clothes, all the clothes that I have. I only packed enough clothes for like a month, and I've basically been living in my Harry Potter t-shirts that I've been getting out of the Geek Gear, the subscription boxes, most of the time. And, you know, it makes me happy to be surrounded by Harry Potter stuff anyway. That's why I'm so glad I got this jumper. It's made me unhappy to not be around it. And all this, I don't know, my head's all over the place right now. I can't believe it's finally happening. Like, we're actually going into our own house. Because we were constantly being told another month delay, it's something that I started to get into my head that it wasn't going to happen, that we were just going to be, pardon the phrase because it sounds cruel, I felt like I was going to be trapped here for like forever kind of thing, you know. I was giving up hope, and Scott has been absolutely incredible. He's organized all this stuff. He's the one that makes sure that documents are sent off with express delivery, and he's just been absolutely amazing in all this. And he knows that I struggle with all this stuff. I struggle with life things. I'm a bit pathetic, really. I feel like I'm a bit pathetic, you know, the amount of anxieties that I have, and the fact that I get anxious about silly little things sometimes. He's just absolutely amazing, and oh, I just can't believe it's actually finally happening. We're on our way to get the keys. Woo! You excited?
Very excited.
Very excited. We're in his sister's van, and there's a whole ton of stuff in there, which you can't see because there's sofa cushions in the way. But yes, the next shot you see will be me opening our door for the first time.
Hello.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah. Na-na. Obviously, no flooring right now. We have bought it, and it will be laid down. We knew that. But yes, here's the entrance hall thing, shindigs. There's the stairs. Here's the kitchen. Cooker. Space for fridge freezer. All of the cupboards. Little space under here. Dobby's cupboard. I don't know why it's always Dobby's cupboard and not Harry's cupboard. With shelves. That'll be cool. The living room. Oh, it's so echoey. And here's the back garden. Outside we have grass and a shed, which is very handy. We have a nice downstairs bathroom. Nice carpets in the bedroom. So this, it's going to be the most exciting bedroom for me, because this is where I'm going to be doing all of my filming and have all my Harry Potter collection. I'm thinking about having my bookshelf like against this wall. We have our actual bathroom in here. bath, shower. I'm so excited that we have a shower. I've not been able to have one in months. Sink, toilet, cool, yes. And this is gonna be our main boudoir. I'm so happy we're finally here. We're finally here. Woo! So yes, it's very echoey at the moment. But we're gonna get this flooring down. Well, that door is right there, and that will work. So echoey. And we're gonna work out where everything is gonna go. And then, yeah, move in, finally. Echoey dance. Right, let's load stuff in. Here's our storage unit. We're already halfway through emptying. Here's one knob and another knob.
You require one?
Yes, please. It's now been a week. I have spent my first week in my brand new home. I'm still so excited and so happy that we have our own place and we're not living with anyone else's parents. It's all coming together slowly but surely. It's starting to feel a bit more like home now. We still haven't got any curtains up, but that's going to be the next big project. We have got a blind in the kitchen now, which we hadn't before, and the kitchen is at the front of the house, and I've always been too afraid to go in there when it's dark outside, and I don't know if anyone else is like this. I hate it, absolutely hate it, when it's dark outside, you've got a light on and there's no curtains, or the curtains aren't drawn. I can't stand it. I have to have the light off if I'm entering a room in that situation. So yeah, I'm glad there's finally a blind in the kitchen. You know, all these things I know are gonna take time, and Scott, my partner, has been really good at sorting it all out, doing all these big bits. We went to the range yesterday and bought loads of curtain poles. We must have bought half of the range yesterday. We bought so many things. And it's all coming together and I'm very excited. We have floor. If you remember when I did the little empty house tour earlier on in this video, we just had concrete on the floor. We now have this nice flooring, which I'm very happy about. We actually bought it before we moved, so this flooring has all been in storage along with the rest of our stuff. And yeah, like I said, I'm just so glad to have our own sofas and our own table and chairs. We actually bought these in the range yesterday, just for a change. We got new cushions, which actually my nan made out of curtains that we bought again before we moved. Scott's bicycle bookshelf is over there, his own little bicycle shrine. I'm gonna do a proper house tour once everything is in its place and everything is done. I don't know if I'm gonna make that into its own video or if it's gonna be like in next month's vlog. I don't know yet. I am planning on doing a Harry Potter room tour because I'm gonna have my own room dedicated to Harry Potter. The second room in this house is my own Harry Potter / YouTube room. So I'm very excited about that. That's very, again, slowly but surely coming together. I filmed my first video today, my Geek Gear unboxing, fabulous box. I love it. I don't think I gave it justice, just how happy I was with the box when I was filming, but it's such a nice box. But yes, as I keep saying, this house is slowly coming together and I'm just so happy and excited. The cat also is so happy. Day one, as soon as we moved in, we put her in a spare room just for her to be accustomed to one room in the house. I opened the door that same day that we moved in and she went exploring straight away. And that was so strange. We didn't think she would do that, because when we moved house the last time, before we moved in with Scott's parents, their last house we actually lived in, it took her and her brother, when he was alive, God rest his soul, it took them like a few days to even leave that room that we put them in, the spare room in that house we put them in. And, you know, it took them a few days to become accustomed, but this cat, she's a little daredevil. I don't know where she is now, sleeping and probably sleeping on our bed. But she just went adventuring straight away, and I think it's because she was stuck in that tiny room in Scott's parents' house for nearly 4 months. We tried to let her out, but because dogs lived in that house, she was too scared to leave the room. I tried taking her outside on a little cat harness just to let her go outside, and she was petrified, bless her. And now she just keeps running up and down the stairs. We don't know where she is from one end to the next. We opened the door the other day. I opened the door the other day to put some washing out in the back garden. She went walking out into the back garden. I didn't think she'd do that for another couple of weeks, but yeah, she's become accustomed to the back garden. She's too afraid to go out the front yet. I think because the back garden is so enclosed, she feels safer to go out there. And I'm just so happy for her. I'm so happy for our little cat. It's actually really nice to get out all of the Christmas presents, all the presents Scott and I got for Christmas, because as soon as Christmas was over, everything went straight into storage, all of our Christmas presents. And so it was really nice to actually get them out and be like, oh, I forgot we got this for Christmas. I forgot we had that. I'd almost forgotten what the curtains looked like that we'd purchased before we moved, and you know, almost forgot about all these different things that we owned because they've been in storage for so long. When we first moved into Scott's parents' house, Scott said to me, in a way this is good because it's going to make you appreciate living in your own home a whole lot more. I didn't see it back then. I mean, yeah, I did know that I'd appreciate it, but also had this like negative feeling towards this house because, you know, they kept delaying us, and I just got it into my head that it was never going to happen, that they were just going to keep delaying us month after month. I just felt like it was never going to happen, and I just wanted to give up and just try and find somewhere else to live. And he said, you know, just wait, you're going to appreciate it. And I had no idea how right he was going to be. I appreciate this house, being in our own home, having our own things, having our own space, so much more than I would have. And another good reason that's a really good thing is because this estate we're in, it's a huge estate. And anyone who knows me knows that I have like travel anxieties. I get anxious every time I'm out and about somewhere I'm not familiar with. I'm always scared to go out on my own. And I'm in a completely different town. You know, I've moved counties, let alone towns. It might just be the next one along, but you know, I don't live in my hometown anymore, and that's the town I lived in my whole life, and this one is a lot bigger. And to go anywhere, I need to either be in a car or be on my bike. So having those few months at Scott's parents' house let me get accustomed to the town I'm living in, plus my new job, before I had to live in this huge estate and trying to get myself about in this estate. And I'm actually a lot more comfortable now than I think I would have been if we moved straight from my hometown to here, if that makes sense. I feel like it actually helped. It's actually a blessing in disguise. So yes, Scott, I know you're watching this. You are right. I do appreciate our own house, living in our own home, a whole lot more than I know I would have if we went straight from my hometown to his hometown, because it's actually his hometown. I don't want to show you too much of the house right now because it's still a bit of a mess. We haven't even had any family members over to look at the house. Scott's dad has been over because he helped him do the flooring. But apart from that, no one else has really been over. I want to have like a little housewarming party. That was always my plan. Have a housewarming party to celebrate us being in our home after nearly 4 month wait. But that's going to wait until, you know, we're happy with the house and we at least need curtains. I'm so excited to get curtains in our bedroom because at the moment we've got like blankets kind of placed in front of the windows. It's also really strange living in this new build kind of place because everyone in this estate, in the newly built part of this estate, are all moving in at the same time. So that's actually really weird. And we're seeing other people day by day moving in. We've got moving vans coming in. And you know, we're all in it together and it feels a little bit more like a community. We're all in it together, which is actually really nice. You know, I don't feel like we're the new ones coming in. You know, when you come into a new street or a new estate, you just feel like everyone's watching you and what kind of lot have we got coming in this time? But you know, we're all in the same boat, which is actually really weird, but really nice. Yeah, I'm really excited and happy. I had to update you guys, and yeah, there you go. It's Friday the 29th of March today. I am off the next 2 days. I'm actually working later on today, but I'm off the weekend. So I'm hoping this isn't going to be the end of the video, so I'm not going to sign off just yet. I'm hoping you'll see more of me. It's Scott's birthday on Sunday anyway. But just in case, maybe I will sign off the video, just in case I don't film anymore. Thank you everyone for watching. I'm sorry that this video is very mismatched and very weird. I think it is a bit weird, this video. There's a lot of talking in this video. There's not much going on, but you know, we've just moved house. That's the best excuse ever, isn't it? You know, as soon as it gets warmer outside, as soon as we've become accustomed to our new home, hopefully there's going to be more stuff going on. So I hope you don't get bored of these videos and just stop watching them, because more exciting things will happen than us moving house, because you know, loads of people move house. So yes, thank you all very much for watching. I really do appreciate everyone who watches my monthly vlogs, because I know they're not my most popular series. I'm very lucky to get over 100 views on these videos, so thank you those of you who do watch my monthly videos. And yeah, this has been my March. I'll see you in April.